Good afternoon. You're listening to WDCE Radio 90.1. My name is Whitney. For those of you who don't know me, I normally have a show on Tuesdays from 4 to 5. Sometimes it's 5 to 6. Lately, it's been 5 to 6. But today, we have a special guest whose name is Josh Urban. And he is actually with me in the studio today.
Hello, Richmond. Good afternoon, and what a beautiful afternoon it is. Thanks for having me by, Whitney. I really appreciate this, and special thanks to the sunbather who helped me sort of find this place.
People here are very helpful.
Yes.
So Josh and I, we actually are going to be doing a show together in a couple of weeks, which is really exciting. Today was the first day we actually met, but I'm going to be asking him a ton of questions.
So questions.
You're going to get to hear some of his answers, which I'm sure will be impressive. And
we can hope.
We can only hope. As you can tell by his radio voice, which is probably better than mine, it's going to be a really good interview. So stay tuned for that. We're going to be playing a lot of random things. It's probably going to be a mix of his taste and my taste combined.
That sounds good.
I don't know if he knows what my taste is yet, but you're going to find out.
That's the best
way. And so let's see. I got to think of what we're going to be playing. What do you want to hear today, Josh?
Well, let's see. You know, I would really like to hear this one. I'd like to... this is on that brought a CD right
here. Let's see what this is.
Yeah, it's a little bit...
It says Sode.
Yes.
Like this, soap with the D.
Well, yeah, that's System of a Down. And this one goes out to my brothers, Noah and Zach, and my mom for introducing me to this. I teach guitar for a living, and my students would always be like, hey, man, you know, you need to listen to this System of a Down band. I'm like, I don't know too much about it. But one day I was trying to... I'm a solo musician, and I was trying to figure out my style, and I was just having an artistic crisis, and I went over to my mom's house and I'm like, Mom, I'm having an artistic crisis. I don't know what to do. And she said, you need to listen to this band. I'm like, nah, it's not good. It's going to be a and she puts a different song by them on. I'm like, wow, that's really cool. So this is kind of a weird sound, but what I'm still getting used to this radio thing. When do I say, and here it is? So wait till you put it in there?
I'm going to work this out. I'm going to play a song by Priscilla on real quick.
Okay, so this is not
you,
what I'm talking about.
You want to introduce the song?
Well, I've never heard this song. So the System of a Down song is coming up in a minute. We're getting this. I'm bedazzled by all of this equipment in here. It's really cool. If you guys haven't been in a radio station before, you really should check it out because it's great. I really... Thank you, Whitney, for having me by. But anyway, yeah, there's just so many styles of music, and I guess we'll be hearing a lot today. So first, this is definitely not System of a Down, not what I'm talking about, but I hope you enjoy and stay tuned for System of a Down, and keep that dial or that mouse right where you have it at WDCE. I've been waiting to say that. Well, that was beautiful and relaxing, like this campus that I had the privilege and honor of walking around. And now here's something that's not relaxing and not beautiful, sort of like my living room when it's not cleaned. This goes out to Noah and Zach and my mom for inspiring me. Hey, man, look at me rocking out. I'm on the radio. Radio Video by System of a Down. Hope you enjoy.
To WDCE Radio 90.1. My name is Whitney, and I am here with my buddy Josh Urban.
Hey, howdy neighbor. How you doing? We're down south, right? So we talk like that.
We are. Yeah. Some of us talk like that. I don't, apparently.
Right. Well, but that's true. Well, it's a diverse campus, I guess.
Very true. I'm representing Washington, D.C.
As am I.
The Northerners. So Josh Urban, he's kind of a big deal. He's from Northern Virginia, and he plays the guitar and he sings. And let's see, some fun facts about Josh Irvin. Apparently, he's a vegetarian.
That's right. I'm 25 now since I was 8. That's the last hamburger I had. It was from Denny's.
Oh, my gosh.
And if anybody had a hamburger from Denny's, that would be the last hamburger they ever had, too. Let me assure you.
Apparently, he's a history and science geek. It was a toss-up between science and entertainment, and here I am.
Yes, yes. I was homeschooled, and I was sitting around the table with my mom one day, and we were trying to figure out what career path I was going to do. And we said, well, it's either science, the sciences, or entertainment. And we both looked at each other and said, entertainment. And well, here I am, and it's great to be here. But I do enjoy science too. I teach guitar for a living. I'm always telling my students, hey, look at this, and it's so cool, and math is the language of the universe, and you can use it anywhere. And one of my 8-year-old students got me, said, you can't use it in the library. And that kind of stumped me for a little while. Yeah, well, I guess he was
sure,
like,
he
it was. That's, I told him he could measure the shelves or subtract the books or something like that. But it tripped me up for a little while. So, but yeah, here I am, and I just recorded a new CD called Signal Man, and that's what I'm
Signal
here
Man.
Promoting. Yes, this was my brother Noah's idea. Everybody's pretty well read in my family, and it actually comes from a Charles Dickens story, sort of a spoof on it, and or not a spoof, but a takeoff. And I've been playing in bands for a long time. And it was fun. I enjoyed it, but just working with other musicians. The musician stereotype is true. It's so true. Well, you know, I break the stereotype because I show up on time and I shower.
I can concur.
And you know, so and I'm sober. So that boggles some people. And they're like, no, man, you're. I give the impression sometimes that I'm not, but I assure you I am. So I was doing this, and after a while I just got really frustrated with it, but I didn't know what to do because I love the big rock sound. And I was talking to a buddy, Miche Fambro. He's a great solo guitarist, and he said, man, you should try to go solo. And I was like, I don't know if I can do this, you know, because I'm kind of into the rock vibe. I love acoustic music, but that really wasn't what I was looking to play. So he said, well, you know, you can do anything you want. So it's been, for about the past 3 years, I've been working on getting a rock sound on stage. And here I am with an acoustic guitar, so I guess it's like Josh Irvin unplugged. But it's definitely been a work in progress, and I don't see a lot of people play solo electric guitar. And I'm not playing it right now. I'm playing solo acoustic guitar. But I wrote a CD last year and recorded it. And boy, what a learning experience.
And that was Signal Man.
That was Signal Man, yes.
Okay.
Yes, and it's more of an EP. It only has 5 tracks, but you can check it out. You can listen to the whole thing for free on my website on joshurban.com. That's joshurban.com. And this is a song I wrote. I was going to visit my grandmother up in Connecticut. And I took the train up because I love trains. I actually explained this story on another track on the CD called Radio WHAM, but that was a fake radio station. This is a real radio station, and this is fun. I could get into this. And I was the train pulled up outside of New York City. It was someplace in northern New Jersey, and I looked out, and I had my songwriting notebook in, and I looked out, and I saw this laundromat. Actually, you know what? I'm getting ahead of myself. A nun was sitting next to me, and I was trying to make conversation with a nun because I obviously didn't have anything in common with her, and she said she had to pray and I probably had to write songs so we should have some quiet time. Seriously! So I was looking out the window just like taken aback, but you know, what can you do? You know, you can't do anything about that. So so I'm looking out the window and I see this laundromat, and it was just so dingy and normal. And everybody always writes a song about, you know, whether it, like it's, if it's a metal song, it's about like an epic battle of yesteryear, or if it's a pop song, it's a love song. And so we have like epic battles and love songs, but nobody really writes about, you know, just anything else, I've noticed.
Like,
you know,
a laundromat.
Right, like a laundromat. Like everybody's like, where do you get off, Josh, writing about a laundromat?
Did you write about a laundromat?
I did write about a laundromat. So, because I saw this laundromat, and I was like, okay, you know, these people, when they're my grandma's age, are they going to talk my ear off about their time at this place? It was called Handy Street Laundromat. So, I'm going to play you this, and let's see if we can make these mics work. Hopefully, it comes through good. They're nice mics. Okay,
so you guys are in for a treat. Our next song is going to be an original from Josh Irvin, live in studio.
Yes, live unplugged.
I mean, I have to say, I don't think you could be more excited.
Oh, man, no, I couldn't. I didn't eat my dark chocolate on the way down because I would have just exploded. Okay, my eyes would have popped out on the side of 95.
Right,
okay, let's see. Good level on that. I see a lot of red lights. la 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 la. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is weird. It's like I'm practicing in my living room, but I'm not. There you have it. A song about a laundromat.
Let yes. Me just say, yes. I am extremely impressed. I've never heard a song about a laundromat.
Well, thank you. Apparently there is a song by Albert King called Laundromat Blues, and I don't want to hear it because, you know, I don't want to be like, oh man, he already thought of that. But but yeah, that's the only time I've heard that. So now we're gonna listen to some real music now.
I think we're gonna go ahead and pass along a PSA for you. So enjoy that, and then we'll have some music coming up for you.
Alert.
Thanks again. You're tuning into WDCE 90.1.
Get your smokies. Always burn. NBA player John Amici scores by coming out. Coming up now on the Rainbow.
Brought to you by Smokey Bear, the U.S. Forest Service, your state forester, and the Ad Council. Learn more at SmokeyBear.com.
A world where massive dust storms roll across the countryside. A world where mud-choked rivers overrun their banks and destroy. Where cities broil under the hot summer sun. A world where crumbling, eroding hillsides wash away in the rain. The Arbor Day Foundation asks you to imagine a world with trees. Conservation trees, where shelter belts tame the wind. Where tree roots grip and hold riverbanks. A world where trees shade homes in the summer and cut cold winter winds. Where lush forests on slopes and hillsides preserve precious topsoil. A world without trees is no world for me or for you. Conservation trees make the difference. This is Eddie Albert. Write for your free brochure from the National Arbor Day Foundation, Nebraska City, Nebraska.
All right, so for anybody who just tuned in, my name is Whitney. You're listening to WDCU Radio 90.1. I am here with my friend Josh Irvin.
Howdy, neighbor. Man, if anybody heard that PSA on Smokey Bear's voice, I want Smokey Bear's voice. Maybe I should move down here to Richmond and get Smokey Bear's voice.
Good luck with that. It hasn't happened to me yet, but...
They'll be like, he's a foreigner, run him out of town.
I'm still waiting for my Smokey Bear voice to come along.
It takes a while. Okay.
Josh Irvin has a lot going on in his life. He's a busy, busy person. And he just had... He released a CD called Signal Man, so we're talking about that. And what I'm wondering, Josh Irvin, who has inspired you?
Who has inspired me? Well, lots of people have inspired me. Musically speaking, I guess some of my biggest influence would be wait, by the way, really dumb question for a radio newbie. Am I close enough to this mic? Is it working? Is it working? And can anybody hear me? Hello out there.
They're not going to answer, but I can say yes there. For them.
Oh, I hear them.
On behalf of
them.
Oh,
wait, no, that's not them. Sorry. So some of my musical inspirations, I'm trying to get this mic dialed in.
You are perfect.
I'm good. Okay.
You're good.
I wish more people said that often. Okay. Said that more often. So some of my musical inspirations, I guess you would say one of my biggest ones was Stevie Ray Vaughan and a lot of the blues-based rock guys like George Thorogood, Jimi Hendrix, of course, the 80s rock heroes like Eddie Van Halen and Joe Satriani, Steve Vai. Well, they're obviously still going strong. And trying to think of a couple of others. I really like jazz a lot. I don't play it a lot. Yeah, but John Coltrane and Charlie Parker, man. Oh, my goodness. And then, of course, before that, I was raised on classical music, so...
Do you listen to piano music?
I love piano music.
Do you know of Jim Brickman?
Oh, no. Oh, no, I don't.
I'll play something later. He's my favorite pianist.
Oh, well, let's check it out.
It's pretty good.
Well, I know up in the D.C. radio station, I was just listening to that today. It's Bach month, and I've...
Bach month.
Oh, man, it's his birthday, I think, on the 24th. I probably shouldn't say things I don't know on the air.
Exciting.
But yeah, it's great, and I remember one of my earliest musical memories, even before I knew I would be a musician, was my parents had this tape. They had this audio tape, for those of you who remember what that was. And my brother was taking a nap, and I had these two little Lego pieces, and I'd listen to this tape. It was like Mozart for kids. And I'd pretend it was a little bitty violin, and I would just saw away on the violin and listen to the violin music. And it was just, it was awesome. I also like funk music a lot. I played in a go-go band. You know what go-go is, Whitney? It's kind of a DC
thing. I picture someone dressed up like a diva in stilettos.
No. Yeah, that's a common misconception. But go-go music is sort of, if you took maybe some Afro-Cuban rhythms and hip-hop and R&B and combined them and put definitely plenty of conga drums in there. That was really cool.
My next guess.
Yeah. There you go. Smart lady. And so all these different musical influences. But the main thing about anything is the intensity that comes through the music. So whether it's System of a Down or Bach, if they're really into it, I really dig it.
Yeah.
So
my only contribution about Bach, obviously he's worth more than this, but I'm taking a guitar class, and my professor calls him Botch.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
So he's like, he wants Sebastian Botch.
I'm pronouncing it wrong. It's like Bach.
Bach.
I don't...
Kind of like French people.
Right. Yeah, well, it's German, so a little bit different. But, but yeah, so anyway, that's my influences.
So that's that. All right, I think... Yeah, let's keep going. All right, so on the back of your CD, it says this album is dedicated to Devin and Kylene. Your silence is deafening. It sounds like there's a story there, so I'm wondering, what the story is.
The story there, yes. Well, it's kind of a somber story, sad story, actually. I'm a pretty, you know, jolly fellow. I'm always going off about stuff. But one of the things I've learned is everybody has a story. And the more people I talk to about this story, I find that my story is similar. So I found it's very important to talk about it. I lost my cousin about 3 years ago. She committed suicide. She was only 18 years old. She's a fine violin player, just amazing. I didn't even really know her that well. And it really, really knocked me for a loop. Made me sad, made me, you know, question all, you know, all this stuff. And I wanted to write a song for her. And I just wasn't sure how to do that. A couple months later, there was this guy. I lost another friend to the same thing, and his name was Devin, and I actually didn't know him that well either. I lost a guitar battle to him years ago.
Oh.
And so he would always remind me of that every time I saw him, and we're always, you know, bantering and having a good time. And he took a couple guitar lessons from me, and I don't know why. Maybe it was just to sit there and say, hey, look at me. I'm on the radio, but no, that's something else. So I was setting up for a gig, and the sound man came by. I'm like, how you doing, man? He's like, oh, man, just got back from a friend's funeral. I'm like, who was it? He's like, Devin. I was like, oh, man.
Oh.
Yeah. So I wanted to write something for them.
Mm-hmm.
So one day I was doing some songwriting, and when I get bored, I read the news, and I get I read the news every 5 minutes because I'm kind of undisciplined, and I was like, I was trying to write a song, and I read this story about they're having a real problem with this over in Iceland. It's an epidemic almost. It's almost becoming a fad.
Mm. Weird combination.
Yeah, it really is. You know, it really is, and they just don't know what to do, and their term for it is called. It translates roughly as Our Lord's Lasso. So I decided to write a song called The Good Lord's Lasso, and that's what's off the CD. And I think it's so important. I mean, I just, a lot of times, and I listen to a lot of violin music too, but I'll just think of Kylie, and I'll see some shred guitar, and I'll think of Devin. And just to let people know that, you know, man, if they could still be here. And I know a lot of people are going through really hard times, and just to let you know that you're not alone. And to get help, and I think we need to start talking to each other. That's really important. So I talk about this before I play it at my shows, and say, you know, hey, you know, if you don't have anybody else to talk to, call me. You know, my website, joshurban.com. You know, drop me an email. Say, Josh, I'm all alone in the world, and I don't know who to talk to. I'll write you back. It's really, really a sad thing. And there's lots of resources out there. Something that's closely related to it, and I want to write a song about it too, is The Cutting. Have you heard about that?
I haven't.
It's I heard about this recently, but it's mainly among girls, but guys will do it sometimes too, but they will they'll take a razor or
the
knife.
Cutting.
Or yeah.
Oh, I thought it was an organization.
Yeah,
yes.
No. Yeah, and
no, I'm aware of The Cutting.
Okay, yeah, and they'll cut themselves on the arm.
Right.
So there's this that's beyond me, and I don't know how to help. So, and the only thing I know how to do is how to talk. So, and that's debatable too.
And he's
so
good at it.
So, well, that's debatable. So I'm always saying, hey, you know, we need to talk to each other. And a group that's really doing a lot of good work with this is the organization To Write Love on Our Arms. I'm sure you've
heard
about
that.
Yes.
There was some sort of holiday on Facebook.
They're really doing a lot of good stuff. And,
and they were
helping a recovering addict.
Huh.
And she had carved this horrible profane message to herself on her arm. So the whole idea was, oh yeah, that CD is really hard to open. You want me to get it
for
you?
No, I got it.
Okay. Trying to open my CD, and anytime I send it off to a promoter, I slit it open because it's hard.
I'm trying to be kind of aloof about it, but he caught me.
Oh, okay.
It's okay.
So, but anyway, yeah, they help this girl, and she tours around the country, and she talks now. So definitely check out their website if you haven't. I believe it's, if you just Google it, To Write Love on Her Arms. .com, I guess, or it might be the first letter of each one. I meant to look it up, but check it out. Let's pull it up on the computer right now.
You keep talking though.
Okay, so I guess the message that I want to get out there is just talk to somebody. Pick up the phone. There's phone numbers. Things will get better. I think our lives are like the sky. And you know, sometimes it's a grade A, but it's almost never a grade A all the time.
If you want to find out more of that, it's TWLOHA.com.
So that's
kind of like Tloha.
Yeah, I know. I was like, what is that? It is To Write Love on Her Arms.
Love
you take
on her
the
arms.
First one. Yeah.
Okay.
So check it out. So this song is called The Good Lord's Lasso, and this is dedicated to my my cousin and my friend. And I'll set up these mics here, see if that works. And I guess, start talking. Wait a second, that's not going to work. I mean, the talking will work, but this mic is not working.
The mic.
Let's see. Stay tuned, good people. Hope you're enjoying the nice day out there. There we go. Okay. Okay, thanks for your patience. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Folks should pay more attention sometimes. Play that violin all day long. And now all that's left is a song. And I'll always have that day burned in my mind. Yeah, tell me what the voices say. Cause the pillow is there, so take them all away. Tell me how to rescue. Lasso.
That was Josh Urban. For anyone who just tuned in, he is live in studio, so you're in for a treat. If you just tuned in, you're in for a treat if you tuned in a while ago. He's been answering some fun questions. We have some other questions coming up that are pretty deep. I was looking through some of the things he's going to be answering, and I am dying to know the answers, so you're going to want to stay around for that. Something we were talking about just a little bit ago was Jim Brickman, who was a pianist, and he is inspired by classical music, so I feel like it's only natural to show you all what that sounds like. So coming up, I'm going to be playing Jim Brickman, The Gift. Again, this is WDCE 90.1. Thank you.
tale come true. Sitting by the fire we made, you're the answer when I prayed I would find someone, and baby I found you. And all I want is to hold you forever, and all I need is you more every day. You say
time stood still, but the colors fade away, and the years will make us gray. But baby, in my eyes, you'll still be beautiful. And all I want is to hold you forever. All I need.
All right, good afternoon. You're listening to WDCE Radio 90.1. My name is Whitney, and I am here with Josh Urban.
How's it going, everybody? What a beautiful afternoon it is, and I am so delighted to be here on the radio. I was just telling Whitney and Robert. That I also told Robert about the inside joke with Robert. But, you know, it's just between me and Robert and Whitney. So you guys are not privy to that. But anyway, I was just telling them about how I'm having so much fun on the radio. And they're like, ah. And I said, there was this one time I was playing at this place in College Park called the College Perk. And I went up and asked for a glass of water to refresh my singing voice. And the bartender was like, do you always talk like that? It's like, talk like what? She's like, well, you're on the radio? But it wasn't a good thing. So I doubt she's listening, but if she is listening, yeah.
Booyah.
Yeah.
All right, so Josh, I have some questions for you.
Yes, ma'am.
If you're ready.
I am ready.
All right, my first question not so much my first, but a question.
A question.
When you're not playing guitar or singing or doing all of these musical things that you do, what do you do?
What do I do? I run around like a chicken with my head cut off. I like to play darts. My brothers gave me a dartboard. I like to do astronomy sometimes.
Astronomy?
Yes.
Tell me about that.
Yes.
How do you do astronomy?
Well, you get a telescope, you see, and you go out in the backyard, and you look at stuff, and you basically imagine that you're seeing something because it's all very faint. And my brothers don't understand it. They're like, it's looking at rocks, man. and technically it is. Technically it's looking at photons. So that's pretty cool. Yeah, so I do that. I'm really fascinated with business, and I want to take over the world with business. And,
really?
And yeah, so even though my brand has this communist theme, which we'll talk about in a little while, I'm definitely a fierce capitalist and look into that. Sometimes I putter on my car, too, because it needs to be puttered on. I love my Camaro, but it needs a little TLC.
Your Camaro.
Yes.
My hairdresser has a Camaro.
Ah, good cars.
His
good
is
cars.
Red. I tried to convince him to give it to me once.
Mine's red, too.
Cool. He said when I turned 21, but I'm scared to ask.
Well, then you go say, hey. So question for you, right back at you.
Sure.
You know, this is a two-way street here. Okay. So you were talking about your music.
My music.
Yeah, and you said you hadn't talked about it on the air before.
I haven't talked about it on
so
the air.
So I want to hear about this. Tell me about it.
Okay, let's see. Well, when I was a young lad, my mom taught me to play piano when I was 7. So I've been playing by ear since I was 7.
Nice.
And that's kind of where it got started. I made a good friend in high school, and she and I started songwriting together. She was more into it than I was at the time. But I have like this binder of poetry, and I would just write and write and write. It's got like over 200 because I was bored one day and counted.
Man.
And I started to
you
turn.
You said 800?
Over 200.
200.
At this
That's
point.
Still
it's probably
a ton.
More now.
Wow.
Now that I'm in college. But yeah. I started turning that stuff into music.
Nice.
And my friend was able to put, you know, background to it and instrumental stuff. And as I got older, I was able to pick up guitar when I was a freshman in high school. And have been playing since. And it was funny, like actually the second month that I was taking guitar lessons, I had an opportunity to play a show at Jam and Java.
Wow, that's a great venue.
It's a wonderful
up there
venue.
In Vienna, right?
And I was so honored to even have any privilege to go up there.
That is great.
And it was a paid gig, my first gig after 2 months of guitar experience.
Holy smokes.
By myself.
Wow.
Up on the stage. And it was pretty cool because the people I was opening for had so many fans. It was definitely like well packed, over 100 people.
Man.
And it was just me and my guitar.
That's great. Oh, wow.
Which was pretty cool. So after that, somebody that was in the audience told me his ex-wife was a vocal teacher, and he put me in touch with her. She had sang on Broadway for 10 years.
He could have been setting you up.
He'd
be like, I hate this lady.
Well, he was just like, you know, you have the power to sound like Kelly Clarkson. Right now you're more of a Colby Calais. So he's like, why don't you work with her?
Wow.
And so I started working with her. And the second show I did at Jam and Java a couple months later was significantly better. And I'm still working on it. I'm taking voice, taking guitar. I've been songwriting.
Nice.
And I play shows. And
that's the thing, is to always be a student of music. You know, no matter how good you get.
Hey.
You know, that's what I tell all my guitar students. Like, I'm still learning. Everybody
always.
Is still learning. And if you stop learning, you sound stale.
It's true.
You know? So, wow, that's really cool.
Yeah.
Well, so what are, you know, because what was the poetry about?
Oh, gosh. I can narrow it down to two subjects.
Two subjects.
Boys.
Boys. Yes, we are confounding.
And hope with boys. It was like bad love stories and hopeful love stories. And that was like the gist of my poetry.
You know, and I'd like to make a public service announcement of my own.
Oh, gosh.
You know, we're so not worth it. You know, we just aren't. Sorry to add you, Robert.
Robert's sitting right behind me with his arms crossed. He's like, dude, really?
I'm going to have to kill you now. But yeah, oh my goodness. You know, look at the girls writing
this
song.
He's in his punching stance. Hey, it's very inspirational, I have to say. You know, Taylor Swift takes a lot of her songs.
Yeah, that's true. Oh, and it'll make you a lot of money. But you know what? I say at least have the writing the songs and have the heartache make you some money. That's my philosophy.
Precisely.
Yeah.
So back to you.
Oh, sorry.
See, look at him. He's like a pro already. So you said something about taking over the world. I heard the word communism. I'm wondering what's your plan?
What's my plan? If I told you, I'd have to kill you.
Oh, no.
But I'd probably be dead because Robert would kill me outing the guys, you know. But, you know, we really are lousy little weasels. Yeah, so you see this shirt I have?
He gave me a shirt.
Yes, it's got my – if people go to joshurban.com/merch and check it out, they can see it. But it's got a picture of me looking like – a Soviet guy with a Cuban hat, and I have like the Asian communist.
It's funny because on the picture, you look like my coworker Andrew, who has a show on the station.
Really?
You look like Andrew.
Boy, you should quit your
it's
job.
Hilarious. I'm tempted to give him the shirt and be like, here, this is made for you.
Yeah. Well, because I'm not a total communist, because tell him to buy one. So it's his sup comrade, and then on the back, it says join the revolution, joshurban.com, and it has a little. Instead of a hammer and a sickle, it has a guitar and a sickle. Mm-hmm. So it's the revolution to overthrow bad music. And I'm recruiting people. So I'm recruiting all of you listeners right now. Go to joshurban.com. Sign up on Facebook. I'm going to start a revolution page. Everybody hates bad music. And of course, you know.
Not true.
Well, okay.
I have
most
a good example.
People.
I'll talk bad about it after.
Bad, well, yeah, because Robert makes an interesting point.
Devil's advocate.
He says, "Oh, we always need one of those around." He says, "Bad music is relative, but bad music is music we don't like, and we usually don't like it for a specific reason, like it's bad or it's stupid. But even more specific, like, well, we all have our reasons. One of my reasons is that people aren't trying. To quote the Annoying Orange, do you all know the Annoying Orange?
Of course.
He says, "You're not trying." So, hey. Can you play some good music? It's fun. So I'm recruiting people to overthrow bad music and to join the revolution and to take over the world and rid the world of bad music. I need a guitar army. So I'm warning you now, comrades. You're either with us or you're against us. So sign up. Go to facebook.com/officialjosh or joshurban.com. That's joshurban.com.
I have a great segue for you. I'm wondering, Josh, be completely honest, what is... Yeah. The worst song you've ever heard?
The worst song I've ever heard.
She'll top it.
Huh.
She will top it.
Let's see. Yesterday. Robert says she'll top. The worst song I've ever heard? Ooh, that would be, man. There are so many of them, you know?
Choose one.
Choose one. Well, gee, nobody's ever asked me that before. Of course, this is the first interview.
It's a great question because you're
taking
over that
right,
music,
and I need to know who's going to be the first to go.
I can tell you one, and then you can think about it while I play this one.
Oh, the stuff I hear in the grocery store. That's
such as?
Well, you know, any of them, all of them, to quote Sarah Palin, you know, anyone that lands in front of me in here, Alaska? No, such as there's one that this is what kind of love makes you go out in the pouring rain? I'm like, that's pretty.
Taylor Swift love.
It's pretty. No, it's not Taylor Swift. I don't particularly care for Taylor's music, but I respect what she's doing.
Well said.
So, but this song is just when you go into the grocery store and you're looking at peanut butter. By the way, don't make a bet with your mom over the price of food because they always win because they shop more. Learned that the hard way. But it's just if you listen, you want to overthrow it. You want to blow up the whole grocery store.
Precisely.
Yeah. So that's a good question, Robert. I'm gonna have to get back to you about that.
All right. Well, there's some controversy over the song I'm going to be playing for you.
It's horrible.
Your ears might start bleeding.
Horrible.
It is just like this new thing.
This is the revolution. We don't need to get enemies of the state in here.
We're gonna pump you up to join the revolution by showing you what bad music sounds like.
This could happen to you.
Don't let people sign you if you cannot write. Listen to the lyrics of this song and try not to cry.
Try not to shoot your ears.
Yes. Right.
Seven, eight. catch my bus. I see my friends kicking in the front seat, sitting in the back seat. Gotta make my mind up.
Stop that noise, comrade. We can't have that. They are the first to go. Rebecca Black is at the top of the list.
He's keeping the list.
I'm keeping score. That's what I'm keeping. Man, oh my
goodness. This is legit. This is real.
And while that atrocity to my ears that made me want to, quote, one of my favorite TV shows, want to weep and then die, Justin Bieber. I'm going to cut his hair.
Justin Bieber.
Yes, yes, yes. Justin. We're going to shave it all off.
Poor Justin Bieber.
And where his power comes from.
Yes. Well, what power does he have?
I got to give Justin Bieber a little bit of credit. Just because his song, well, like Rebecca Black, but slightly less painful.
Watch
just
it, Whitney.
Let me say.
Watch it, Whitney.
I
hope you like
say,
gulag stew. I'm just saying.
Try something. I dare you. I'm just going to say, a cover was done. Have you watched Glee? Do you ever watch Glee?
No,
You don't watch Glee? Okay.
I watch The Office.
Well, The Office is wonderful.
And I'm like Steve.
I mean,
Michael.
Steve. I was going to say, I can see Michael. I don't know about Steve Carell. So, Glee covers songs. Oftentimes good songs, oftentimes bad songs that become good songs. They covered Baby. And I am not opposed to their cover. So I'm going to show it to you. And you can rip
it apart.
There's
Justin Bieber on
my
show, Whitney.
You can rip it apart.
If this was a courtroom, I would object.
If you're going to fight me against Justin Bieber, I want to hear a solid argument.
Cue it up, comrade.
All right.
Cue it up.
All right.
The following clip is brought to you by St. Baldrick's Foundation.
Oh, oh, oh. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, oh, oh. You know you love me, I know you care, just shout whenever. And I'll be there. You want my love, you want my heart, and we will never,
this
ever, ever
really
be apart.
Song.
Oh, we unite them. Girl, quit playing. We're just friends. What are you saying? Say there's another and look right in my eyes. My first love broke my heart for the first time, and I was like, baby, 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 oh. Baby, baby, no, like baby, baby.
No, comrade. I don't know. I think the parameter is.
It looked like a mixture of anger and laughter, and I saw some emotions going on. I don't know.
Yes, there's lots of emotions going on in my face. They just couldn't all come out. You know, I don't know. Anything Justin is just, you know, it's not for the cause. You know, I'm sorry, Whitney. I mean, it's entertaining, but you know, it's just another
thing. What do you think is the biggest problem with Justin Bieber?
Well, you know. A lot of musicians slam him because he's famous, and they're not. So I'm not going to do that because I'm working on it. And you are helping my cause here, so thank you. Thank you, Richmond. But
I'll say this. He did work his way up.
No, he didn't work his way up.
I'm not going to argue that.
Since he was 12 till he was 14, he didn't work his way up.
I mean, he's 12 years old.
He started on YouTube, you know. I don't have any respect for him, don't get me wrong. But because he did kind of steal my best friend's last name, and I can't really say... Hey,
yeah, and you know what? And you know, he's taking a month to grow a mustache, man. And he's going to see if he can grow one.
He hasn't even hit puberty yet.
Yesterday.
Give him some credit.
Okay, but still, he's a girly man. A girly man is a thing I borrow from Arnold Schwarzenegger, and that doesn't have anything to do with orientation.
You gotta say it like Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Girly man! Yeah, yeah! So it just has to do with your intensity with life. And look at his hair, man. Look at his hair. Okay, so it's better than mine, but still, he's going down. He's going down. Okay, so now.
So now, Josh has talked me into this. I have been singing and playing guitar for a while. And my buddy Robert's way better at guitar than I am. He's my boyfriend. I like the word buddy more than boyfriend. It flows off the tongue better. He's my buddy and my boyfriend and my partner in crime. Well, and I like him.
Yeah, so we're going to hear, this is historic.
This is historic. This is the first time I've played on the radio. So.
Yes, and she's the program manager.
And I am the program director.
Yes, so I'm sitting here with the big boss and the buddy.
I can fire people.
And yes, so we're going to hear, what song are we going to hear, Whitney?
I'm going to play Sarah Bareilles, One Sweet Love.
Well, I'm going to get schooled because I don't know the song, so.
That's really easy.
Sit back and enjoy.
Really easy. All right. I'm not really, okay.
You got this.
I suppose I got this, I mean.
Hey, he doesn't like my guitar.
He doesn't like the guitar.
Here, so we're going to switch over to the guitar. Hold on a second.
It's a bit
Josh was prepared and came with
two guitars.
Yes,
I brought two guitars.
Josh knew this was going to happen.
He's running on that exact guitar.
He's running, I kid you not, that is the one I have.
He's running on comrade credit.
That almost scares
but we'll give
me. You have my guitar.
Wait, I'm running on who? What?
On comrade credit, man. You insulted
comrade
my
credit.
Guitar.
All right, Josh, let's converse while
let's
we're
see. Okay.
While we're waiting.
So,
let's have a conversation.
So anyway.
All right, Josh, I'm wondering. You ask me questions or I'll ask you questions.
Okay, so, well, a couple questions here is, how is the music scene around here? Because I'm from the D.C. area, and I can't wait to meet the people in the music scene. I really want to play at the college. I was talking to Nick over at Bogart's, and you guys should definitely check that out. Give them a plug.
Bogart's.
Check that out. Yeah. I don't know if you've been there or not. I just looked at their website, and it looked pretty cool, and I definitely want to go and play over there. Unfortunately, we weren't able to work out a show this week, but
interesting.
Does Robert need a tuner?
Sorry,
Nick, I'm messing up your plug here. But yeah, so what's the scene like around here? Because I really can't wait to get involved with it.
All right, well, back when I was a young high school student, I remember looking at Richmond, and everyone was like, oh, you are into music. Go to Richmond. The music scene's awesome. So Here I am. I have met a number of artists in the area. Not a ton, but a number. I have a friend who's in a band called Sunnest Day. I'm constantly talking about them.
Nice.
They have actually kind of hit it off through Richmond.
Very cool.
My friend Eric is a producer, and I met him in Richmond and hooked him up with Taylor. And now Taylor and his band are on their way to Los Angeles.
Wow.
Because they got some music in a movie.
Wow, man, that's
and
great.
The name of the movie is slipping my mind. But they are kind of working their way up.
That's
and
great.
It's kind of, I mean, I hate to say this, but you've probably heard it before. It's kind of about who you know.
Oh, yes.
And the thing about Richmond is that everybody knows everybody. So you meet someone, they know someone, you get in touch with them, you have coffee, there are 1,000 Starbucks in Richmond.
Nice.
You go to a show, promote a band, support a band, and they will help you out.
That's awesome. Well, I feel privileged and honored to be sitting here with a big boss in the studio.
He's older than I am.
Yeah, so that doesn't care. It doesn't matter, you know? It's like, man, this is cool. This is cool. Well, that's great. Well, well, if you're up in the D.C. area, let me know. And I'll
live in the D.C.
area. Oh, you live in the D.C. area.
You know
that. Okay, that's right. But if you want to play a show up there, just let me know and I'll be glad to help you out.
Know.
Okay, we got.
Okay, so Robert's back.
We got the guitar
all
set.
We're Sarah Bareilles, Sweet Sweet Love. This is my voice here.
I mean,
so enjoy or don't. It's up to you.
Don't enjoy, please.
Please try.
Please don't. sorry.
Just about the time the shadows fall, I undress my mind and dare you to follow. Paint a portrait of your mystery.
You started late.
Do you want to do it again?
Yeah, we'll
really,
start over.
I really want to hear this. I really want to hear this.
Really
Let's
start.
You told me when to come in. You're giving me dirty looks.
Let's see.
Though you know
I'm trying.
It's because he's got a Redskins jersey on. That's why. That's why.
Just kidding.
Not yet. After this. That's when you would
just about the time the shadows call, I undress my mind and dare you to follow. Paint a portrait of my mystery. Only close my eyes and you are here with me. A nameless face to think I see, to sit and watch the wave for me until they're gone. A heart I'd swear I'd recognize is made out of my own devices. Could I be wrong? The time that I've taken, I pray it's not wasted. Already tasted my piece of wine, sweet life. Sleepless nights you creep inside of me. Picture shadows on the breath that we share. You take more than just my sanity. You take my reason not to care. No ordinary wings I need. The sky itself will carry me back to you. The things I dream that I can do, I'd open up the moon for you. Just come down soon. The time that I've taken, I pray it's not wasted. Already tasted my piece of wine, sweet love. I'm ready and waiting for a heart worth the breaking. I'd settle for an honest mistake in the name of wine, sweet love. Savor the sorrow to soften the pain. Sip on the southern rain. As I do, I don't look, don't touch, don't do anything, but hope that there is a you. space between, I'd banish it from under me to get to you. Your unexpected love provides my solitary suicide. Oh, I wish I knew the time that I've taken. I pray it's not wasted. Have I already tasted my piece of wine, sweet life? I'm ready and waiting for a heart worth the breaking. Ooh, I'd settle for an honest mistake in the name of wine, sweet life. One sweet life.
Yeah! I don't know how to clap into these mics, but that sounded great. Thanks, Sarah.
Thanks.
Thank you, sir. Very
that
nice.
That was a Sarah Bareilles cover.
Very nice, yeah. And those, so that's Rob on the guitar and Whitney on the vocals, and that was
up a little bit.
That was cool. Okay. That was cool. Nobody noticed me.
Rob
that,
was just insecure.
That was
it's all right.
That, aren't we all?
It's all good. So coming up, we are going to be chit-chatting a little bit. The show's going to be ending in about 15 minutes, give or take. But we have some time for some questions, and we have some time for some more good music.
I want to play another song.
And Josh wants to play another song. So Josh is going to play another song. I would say we can just go ahead and jump right into that.
Sure.
What the heck.
All right.
It's going to be Josh. Josh, what are you playing?
Well, okay. Well, this is one of the things.
Oh, yes. Oh, thank you, sir. All right. Hello.
Much better.
So, and by the way, for those of you just tuning in, please, here's my relentless self-promotion. Please go to my website, www.joshurban.com.
You guys, I don't know if you realize this, but he's a really big deal. He's got CDs. He's got a site. Like, this guy's legit, guys.
That's money can buy legitimacy, I guess. So I just, yes, it is true. I just paid for that. So I'm not signed, but I'm working on it. What was I gonna say? One of the things about music that I'm sort of learning about is, man, as a student and as somebody who's trying to get this thing off the ground, you really gotta be dedicated, you really gotta be focused. But at the same time, you don't wanna take yourself too seriously.
No.
Yeah, right. You know, music to me,
that's a big mistake.
Oh, isn't it? You know, and everybody's like, oh, look at me. And it's like, gee, okay, well, whatever, man, you know. But one of the things for me that I've noticed, because I did a lot of intense guitar study, scales and, you know, shred and everything, and music is more just an interpretation. Well, it can be anything you want, but for me, one of the things I'm really excited about is turning it into an interpretation of the world. So it's almost like a camera. You can interpret the world. So like with the laundromat one, just sort of like looking at something and presenting it in an unusual
Two
way.
Two questions. Is it on your CD?
This song.
Okay, I was gonna try and guess.
Yeah, this song is a cover.
Okay.
And I was talking to my mom last night. I stopped by and was visiting, and somehow the song came up. And it's funny because when I run into people, I'm known for this song, and it definitely keeps me from taking myself too seriously. So Richmond, why don't you sit right back? And oh, I'd like to. I don't know if she's listening or not, but I'd like to send this one out to Jan. Jan, I appreciate your support of this song and of my music. So, anyway, why don't you sit right back, Richmond and Worldwide Interweb, and I may tell you a tale of three little pigs and a big bad wolf. You're gonna like this, Robert. That I'm crazy. So, yeah. This'll do it, right? Well, the first little piggy, well, he was kinda higgy. Spent most of his days just a dreaming of the city. Then one day, he bought a guitar. He moved to Hollywood to become a star. Living on the farm, he knew nothing of the city. Built his house out of straw, what a pity. Then one day, jamming on some chords, along came the wolf. Little pig, let's me in. Not but a pearl, but chitty chin chin. Little pig, let's me in. Not but a pearl, but chitty chin chin. Well, I'm hopping. puffin', blow your house in. Huffin' and a puffin' and I'll blow your house in.
And probably the radio transmitter. And everybody's boomboxes. And there's more verses.
Well, the second little piggy, well, he was kind of stoking. Spent most of his days in the sun just soaking. Hopping and a bopping down on Venice Beach. Getting paid money for religious speech. Built his shelter from a garbage pit. Mostly made up of old cans and sticks. Then one day he was cranking up a Marley. Along came a wolf on his big bad Harley. Little pig, lets me in. Little pig, lets me in. Well, I'm huffing, I'm puffing, I blow your house in. Huffing, puffing, blow your house in. Huffing, puffing, blow your house in. Huffing and I'm puffing and I'll blow your house in. What do you think, Robert? Convinced? Okay. Well, the third little piggy, a grade A student, his daddy was a rock star named Pig Nugent, earned his master's degree from Harvard College, built his house with his architect knowledge, a tri-level mansion, Hollywood Hills, daddy's rock stardom paid for the bills. Then one day came the old house masher, the big bad wolf, the little piggy slasher. Little pig, let me in. Look by the hair of my chinny chin chin. Little pig, let me in. Look by the hair of my chinny chin chin. Well, I'm huffing, I'm puffing, I'll blow your house in. Huffing, puffing, blow your house in. Huffing, puffing, blow your house in. Huffing and I'm puffing and I'll blow your house in. Well, the big bad wolf, he huffed and he puffed all that he could. And lo and behold, little piggy's house stood. It's made out of concrete, the little piggy shouted. The wolf just frowned as he pouted. So they called 9/11 like any piggy would. They sent out Rambo just as fast as they could. Accent here. Yo, wolf face, I'm your worst nightmare. You're mine now. Ah! Well, the wolf fell dead, as you can plainly see. And that's the end of the story for you and me. But still give a listen, and you just may hear the big wolf, the little piggy say, little pig, let me in. Little pigs, let me in. Look by the hair of our chinny chin chins. Well, I'm huffing, I'm puffing, I'll blow your house in. Huffing, puffing, I'll blow your house in. Huffing, puffing, I'll blow your house in. Huffing and I'm puffing and I'm huffing and I'm puffing and I'm huffing and I'm puffing and I'll blow your house in. Three little pigs. There you go.
Goodness gracious. Now we know why he's remembered.
Yes.
For that one.
Oh my goodness.
That was fabulous. For anybody just tuning in, I am sorry for you guys. You have missed a fantastic interview with Josh Irvin, who is a singer-songwriter / performer from Washington,
Revolutionary. / overthrowing the world. Your boss
of overthrowing
pretty soon.
Bad music. Yep. So I've been recruited. I got a t-shirt, which means I'm in.
Yes.
Officially.
Robert, he's wearing red, so he's in too.
Robert's in too. So we're going to be wrapping up pretty soon. I am wondering for Josh, I want to go out with a bang. What is the best song you know that we could end with to start this revolution?
Let's see. What's my favorite song? Can we play one off my CD? Is that cool?
Sure.
It's not my favorite song ever, but my favorite song off my CD. Let's go out with the Laundromat song. The real one is track 4. It's called Handy Street. And for those of you just tuning in to Radio WDCE 90.1 Richmond, and the worldwide interweb, please go to my website, www.joshurban.com, and join the revolution to overthrow bad music. Here's a song I wrote about a laundromat, the past, the future, and portraits of the ordinary. It's available for free on my website or off my new EP called Signal Man.
So enjoy. we're gonna be wrapping up soon. This is pretty much the end. So we're gonna go out with this song that he was saying, Laundromat. So from home, I just want you to clap and give Josh Irvin a round of applause.
Thank you.
He's fabulous.
And Whitney, thank you so much for having me.
You're so welcome.
Really appreciate it. Robert, thanks for moving your computer so we can record this. And oh yeah, it'll work. It's Apple. It's great.
Yeah, but it's Facebook.
So well, true. But hey, but thank you both very much. Really appreciate
you
it.
Are
and
so
yeah, everybody,
welcome.
Check out joshurban.com. Want to see you online.
All right, and this is
Signalman.
Josh Urban, Signalman
is the name of the album, and then the track is Handy Street.
Handy Street.
Oh, I gotta take this call.
Forever and a day. The cheapest soap, the cheapest knives. The sky is always gray.